Well, we're now joined by Evan and Mark Chevery. It's great talking to you guys, brothers. If I could just start with you, Mark, how are you finding the Elite League?
It's a lot of fun. The hockey's very competitive, and you know, it's nice to see a lot of new places and you know, playing against my brother, that's for sure.
Evan, what advice did you give him before he came here?
I just said keep an open mind. Things are going to be a little different, but it's similar to back home. You know, most of the guys come from back home, and the British or local guys are all very, very good hockey players and good people. So just go about your business and have a little fun.
Now, Mark, you're here as a kind of joint collaboration with Dundee University. You must have been delighted when you got the call to say it all went through and you had the two things here when you came to Dundee.
Yeah, absolutely. Education's very important to our family and important to me, and I was very feel very fortunate and blessed to get that opportunity and look to make the most of it.
Do you think it'll be a challenge to balance both things as the year goes on?
I think just hockey in general is going to be a challenge, let alone school, but it'll be fun nonetheless, and I look forward to it.
And you've played a lot of places, AHL, ECHL. What experience do you think you bring to the league, considering you have to kind of live in the name after Dan Bacala being here last year?
Yeah, I mean, I just try and do my thing, and I think I bring a solid foundation of experience, and you know, last year was last year, and Dan had a great year, but, you know, this year is different, and you know, I'm not going to try and compare myself to what he did. I'm just going to do what I'm going to do.
That's great. And Evan, tonight you did score, but it wasn't against your brother. Empty net goal, but you must be really delighted to have him here with you across in the...
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, for sure. It's, you know, geez, we're 7 years apart, and it's crazy to think that we're playing against each other. When I look back, we played street hockey as young kids, and now we're playing against each other. So it's pretty cool. You know, I'm going to be rooting for him. We're obviously in different conferences, so I want him to do as well as possible, you know. And but when we're head-to-head, you know, we're both going to compete, and hopefully Belfast wins.
When you saw the fixture list and you were playing against each other tonight, what did you guys say to each other?
I think we just first noticed that it was the first game of the season, so it was, definitely a quick start into things, and, you know, we'll be looking forward to the next one, that's for sure.
And, Evan, big weekend for the Giants, three games against Scottish sides. What do you take from tonight?
It's a good start for us. You know, obviously we have a lot of returning guys, so it's kind of easy for us to get back into the swing of things, and I thought tonight showed that a little bit. You know, they did come back and put some heat on us for a good portion of the game, but, you know, we battled, and I think every team's good. It's going to be a battle every night. Games are going to go either way. We expect more of the same from Brayhead and Edinburgh, so we're just one period at a time. It's cliche, but it's true.
Do you think having so many of the players back from last season gives you a strong hand, especially at this time of the season when, say, Dundee Stars are trying to get themselves together?
I think so. You know, we only switched over two or three guys, so it's kind of a well-oiled machine coming in, and you know, hopefully we can refine it and let the other guys adjust. Obviously, you saw a guy like Ray Sawada played well tonight. He's fitting in, and Compon was in on a goal. So these guys are adjusting. It's only hopefully going to get better for everybody. And, if we win, that's great.
Well, that's great for talking to us, guys. Thank you very much.
All right, thank you.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Cheers. Well, thanks for talking to us, Jeff. Not what you expected tonight, I'm sure.
No, I think there was a lot of positives. I think, you know, they scored two power play goals, and the other goal that they got was offside. So, I mean, I think, you know, it wasn't from a lack of effort. I think there was a lot of effort across the board. I think our goaltending was fantastic. I think he didn't have a chance on any of the goals that were in. A lot of positives. I'm gonna sit here and dwell on a few mistakes, because that's what they were, is a few mistakes. And a good quality side like Belfast, when they get opportunities, they finish them. And you know, we've got more guys to add into the lineup, and you know, the chemistry will start to get there. And you know, there's been, over the last four games, there's been a lot of chances to score. And I thought we piled the pressure on in the second. And at the end of the first. So it's just about sustaining that pressure for the 60 minutes, and it will come. I told the guys not to get your heads down. It's going to come, and we'll move forward.
Do you think you've seen a good progression, to be fair, since last weekend to this present day?
Yeah, I mean, definitely, like, playing playing Belfast, I think we played a lot better against Belfast than we did against Edinburgh the two games. I think, you know, and that boils down to the style that Edinburgh play. You know, I thought we did a really good job in the first period. I think, you know, it was even, you know, 7-7 shots and, you know, scoring chances on both sides. And one falls for us, and maybe it's a different game. And, you know, maybe we were on the other end of the bounces. But, you know, I'm not going to dwell on it too. It's game one of 60. So, I mean, it's not one we lost on the first game.
Have you got an update on Jade Galbraith?
Yeah, the update is that there is no update. The visa is, I've personally seen his visa, that they've received his paperwork. And, you know, I know Belfast were having trouble with a few of their guys, and some of their guys were taking 3 to 4 weeks, even though they paid for priority service, which is not great. But again, I don't want to dwell on, you know, on who's not here. We have to worry about who's in the lineup at the present moment. And, kind of work with that, and then, you know, he's one person and one player, and you know, we're not going to count on him every night to win, so we shouldn't do that now.
Yeah, no, I mentioned in players, is there any possibility of bringing another D-man in?
There's lots of possibilities. You know, I'm looking at a number of things. You know, the Swindlehurst thing is a big blow to us, and you know, it's not something that you can easily replace overnight, especially as a young Brit. So there is pressure to kind of fill that void. But the guys that played tonight, and even young Robbie Hill, I thought they played well. I think, you know, again, if you look back on what the game was, is the game was two power play goals and an offside goal. So, I mean, I thought for the most part, the D played pretty well. I'm really happy with Kevin Quick. I think he's a fantastic player. I think he showed his quality tonight. I think, you know, he skates himself out of so many situations and led the rush. And when we do have some more guys back there, I think that he's going to be a very, very valuable asset there. So, again, positives, all positives, and not a lot of negatives, to be honest.
Well, no more games this weekend for the team. Is that seen as a positive to yourself, or would you have liked to have got back on the ice this weekend?
No, I think it's a positive. I think it's a positive in the fact that we don't have our full lineup. Gives us extra days to practice. So, and it breaks up, you know, playing some, you know, some championship contenders right away. It gives us a little bit of time to find our chemistry in practice. And I see it as a positive. It's kind of, you know, it is a good thing for us. We'll get back into next weekend playing Coventry. And then we got a big game at home against Hull. And, you know, I've always said it, that the Gardner Conference is the you know, the number one aim for us, and it goes through those games against Hull, Fife, and Brayhead.
That's great. Thanks very much, Jeff. Thanks for your time.